Переведите ему, пожалуйста. Куда пришел? Привет.
Hey guys, what's up? So, as many of you probably already heard or read about, maybe on Facebook, maybe you saw my post about it, maybe on a metal webpage or a metal webzine, because by now everybody that has to do a little bit with metal already wrote about it or made a video about it. So I thought to myself, why not? The Austrian band Belvigor, which I'm a huge fan of, together with Niall and I believe another band, but I'm not really sure. We're going on a tour through Russia. They were supposed to play a few shows there, but when they arrived on the airport in Russia, there were a few Orthodox fanatic Christians waiting for them, and there are two versions of the video what this is all about. There's one that's like 2-3 minutes long, and there's a longer version which is around 10 minutes. And in the longer version you can see these fanatics before Belvigor and Niall arrive interview a metal couple, asking them like, are you a Satanist? What do you think of Satanism? Do you hate Christians? Are you gay? What do you think of gays? Do you support gay people? Do you know that Belvigor is gay? And you know, for somebody that's really anti-gay, they really focus a lot on homosexual people. And just asking dumb shit as like, do you know that the guys from Belvigor fuck goats? And I'm like, even if that's true, how does he know that? Anyway, and this couple, or at least the guy from this couple, is like really awkwardly trying to answer all those questions. And then when Belvigor and Niall arrive, they step into the main hall of the airport. This guy, this older man, walks up to Helmut, starts talking to him, and you can see Helmut like, hey, I don't want to talk to you, I just arrived. And at that moment, the fanatic Christian spits Helmut right in the face. Now, this may be a personal thing, but I would rather get a punch to the face than be spat in the face, because it's so fucking humiliating. And I personally think that everyone that spits another person in the face just because you don't agree with views or you think differently than that other person really needs to be locked up in a brass bull. Now, for everybody that doesn't know what a brass bull is, it's an ancient form of execution where they would make a brass bull, put you inside of it, light a fire underneath it, and you would actually get roasted inside that bull. And your screams would get out of the bull, and it would sound like a scream of that bull. The roast off had a completely different meaning back in those days. So yeah, it's like really fucking humiliating, and I really don't think that Helmut deserves any of this, and also not the backlash that he got from people online on how he responded. Because as I also said on Facebook, I really deeply respect the way that these guys responded, because they actually really didn't. You can see Helmut backing off, starting to curse in his own language, spit back at this guy and just push him away, and he just walks off trying to avoid this guy. In the meanwhile, Carl Sanders of Niall stays between these fanatics and between the fanatics and Helmut. And a lot of people said, like, why didn't he punch the lights out of that guy? You know, he's a pussy, why didn't he punch back? Well, I've never been to Russia, but I think that we can all agree that you don't want to get into trouble in Russia. You don't want to mess with authority. And you might think to yourself, like, but he gets spits in the face, you know. This group of fanatics has more influence on police and government than, for example, the Westboro Baptist Church. You know, these people are no more than the Westboro Baptist Church of Russia. Difference is that these people have more influence on the government and police than those assholes from America. But that's as far as I know. You know, these are people that hate gay people, they hate soldiers, they hate metalheads, and they think we all go to hell. Even they go to hell, because even if they do God's work, we are all going to hell. So I would say, like, these guys are really shit out of luck because they hate us all and we're all going to hell. So we're going to see them there and we're going to bring our music. But I personally think that Helmut, Carl Sanders and all the rest of the people did an excellent job responding to this the way they did by not escalating it further than it had to be, because they would definitely go to jail. These people spit you in the face because they think you're a Satanist. For them, that's justice. You know, you don't deserve anything more than to be spat in the face. So if you would punch their lights out, they would see that as an unjustified attack. This would only give these people more fuel for their rage against metalheads and metal bands in general. They will have another argument to say to government, to media, to police, like, see, that's what you get when you invite Satanists to your country, you get attacked for nothing. Because even though they spit you in the face, they see that as something normal. That's what you deserve. So if they would get punched in the face, they see that as injustice. And there's just no reasoning with these people. You know, they use unlogical bullshit as their argument. And you can try to reason with these people and you can try to punch their shit out. That's not going to change anything. So the best thing that Helmut and Carl Sanders and all the rest of the guys could do is exactly what they did. Respond as less as possible. You know, the only thing you see in the longer video is that Helmut walks to the van where they were, where they stepped in and drove off, just pointing his middle finger to the camera, like, fuck you all and fuck you all. And that's just something he said. Perfect. You know, just absolute perfect. He's not a pussy for not responding or punching this guy's lights out. I personally think that he thought to himself, like, yeah, we're in Russia now, you know, just... Even though this guy deserved to be crucified upside down, it's not the smartest thing to do when you're in Russia. You know, we all know that you really don't want to mess with authority there. And you don't want to end up in a Russian jail. Because if he would get arrested for blasphemy or whatever, who knows how long he would stay in jail. You know, there's just no justice as it exists here. And there are a bunch of people that responded with, like, fuck Russia and fuck the Russians. And no, you know, there are a lot of metalheads in Russia. There are metal bands from Russia, some really good ones. So it's not a Russian problem. There's this little group that just has a fucked up influence on media and authority. So they screw it up for a lot of people in Russia. So it's not a Russian problem. Russia is not fucked up. The government who allows this and these kind of people, those are fucked up. And a lot of metalheads and metal bands are the victim of a fucked up system. That's what it is. So it's not the entire Russian population. It's not the entire country. It's just a group of people with too much influence. And as even Dallas Toller Wade, the vocalist of Nile, posted on my post on Facebook, it's not even a religious problem. It's a fanatic religious problem. And yes, there is a difference. Because I know for a fact that I have people in my friends list on Facebook, Jews, Muslims, Christians, maybe even Scientology supporters, I'm not really sure, but they all just don't give two shits for the lyrics of Belphegor or even Dark Funeral or whatever. They like the music, they support the bands, they even have the CDs. So there are Christians, there are Muslims that just love Belphegor as much as I do. So it's not a religious problem. You know, I just not try to put everything and everyone in the same fucking group, like, it's all religion, it's all Russia. No, it's... I personally think you just can't do that, you know? Just, it's not... I mean, I would personally hate it if there was a group here in Amsterdam that would try to sabotage metal shows, spit people in the face, which in Amsterdam is really not a... smart thing to do, because as much as you don't have to try to do it in Russia, nobody gives a shit here. You know, if you would do it here, if I would get spit in the face here in Amsterdam by some Christian asshole, I would wipe the floor with him, really. But I would really hate it if I would see people say like, oh, fuck Amsterdam or fuck the Netherlands, because, no, I mean, I'm also here and I'm from Amsterdam, and, you know, it's, you can't put everyone in the same fucking group. I do, however, think that bands should consider to themselves whether they want to go to Russia to perform there, because as it says here on a website, there was also a cancelled tour of a Polish black metal band called Batushka. You know, so an entire tour got cancelled because of these kinds of people. And it's really fucked up that they get exactly what they want, because as Dallas from Nile also said, at one show, Belfagor was not allowed to sing their lyrics and just play the music, and at the last show they weren't even allowed to play at all. Excuse me. So, you know, it's really fucked up that these guys have so much influence on tours, on shows and whatever, and there are a lot of people in Russia that suffer from this, because there are a lot of Russians that just want to see the bands come to their country and to see them perform and to support these bands and to go to the shows. And I think that's really fucked up. But I think that, as I said, Belfagor, Helmut and Carl Sanders did an excellent job, and it's just bullshit to say that they should have punched their lights out. You know, you're in the wrong place to do that. You don't want to do that in Russia. So, yeah, it's just, as I said, it's completely fucked up. And I will always support Nile, and I will always support Belfagor, and I can't wait to see these guys again somewhere. So, let me know what you guys think. You know, do you think, like, it's really a religious problem? Do you think the entire country of Russia is fucked up? I don't think so. You know, it's just a group of people, and you can't put everyone in the same spot. But yeah, it's really fucking humiliating to do this, you know. So hail Helmut, hail Belfagor, and I hope to see you guys next time. Oh, of course, hail Nile. So let me know what you guys think. It's a fucked up situation, and I hope it will get better someday in Russia. You know, maybe people will lighten up a little bit more, get a little bit more open-minded, and let's hope the best for the future. So, like I said, let me know what you think, and I'll see you guys next video. Yeah.